Hi, Rail from Checkfront here. Let me walk you through the steps for seasonal item events. Let's start by going to Inventory, Item Events, New Item Event. You'll see here that we can set the inventory status to, say, unavailable for closure item events or available. So in this case, let's do a seasonal item event. We use this for, say, peak season, low season. In this case, let's do winter season special. So let's change the price from the base price because we want a reduced amount for our special. We could choose, for instance, dynamic pricing and do -10% perhaps. We could also create a new price point. Let me show you what this looks like. Let's do a reoccurrence. So we can select perhaps weekly. We could make this item event only apply to weekends or weekdays. We could also select always don't expire, or we can give this a winter season start and end date. We can also force the item length to the above and start dates if we want customers to have to choose this as the start date and this as the end date, or we can not select this so that they can then choose any date in between. We can add specific time slots. We can add rule sets to apply to, this, and we can always choose which items we'd like to apply this to. So let's say accommodations. You can also choose which items specifically you would like to apply it to within that category. Make sure to save your changes. If we've selected create new price point, let's go into your item. In this case, I selected King Deluxe Room, and you'll see in the pricing tab, if I scroll down to pricing table, there's now an option to change this base price. So I'm going to make it $150. I'm going to save those changes, and let's see what this looks like on the customer booking page. So it's currently $185 for September, but if I select one of those winter dates, the price has now adjusted based on the price I've selected for that season. So I hope that helps you make seasonal item events, and happy bookings. Bye for now.